Hello, I'm Michael Collins, and today what I'd like to show you is this combo button. So this is in Bubble. I'm putting together a style guide for a project, and I just put together this combo button and thought I'd share what I did. So let's go into it. And I made another box group, group over here. And the first thing that I'm going to do is put in a group. And this is going to be the combo button container. And the layout is going to be a row. For now, I'm going to uncheck make this element fixed width and then leave everything else the same. For now, I'm going to grab a button and I'll put the button in. I already have a primary button style styled, but it has rounded corners on all sides. So what I'm going to do is go and I'll make a new one. So let's find the button primary, and we'll make a new one and call this combo button. We'll define each border independently by checking the box. The top left will be 8. Top right will be 0, bottom will be 0, bottom left will be 8. And I'm actually going to take the shadow off of this. We'll put the shadow on the combo group. And we'll leave the hover the same, layout the same, everything else the same. So let's go back to the design. And we'll change this to the primary combo button. Then I'm going to take a material icon and pop that into our row group and look for an arrow. And we'll use this down chevron. The color, I'm going to use the same as the text color in the primary button, which is the primary contrast. In the layout, I'm going to do width 48 and height 48. So let's go back to the actual primary button to the layout, and we'll do the minimum height as 48. I'm going to uncheck the make this element fixed width. The minimum width will be 10. The max width will be infinite, but I will check this fit width to content. And under the appearance, let's change this to save and publish. Now let's style our icon. Since there isn't a style associated with it, we're going to create a new style. So let's change the background style to flat color, and we'll change that color to primary. We'll define each border independently. So the top right will be 8, the bottom right will be 8. And then on the border style left, we're going to do a solid. We'll do 2 pixels and we'll change the color to the primary contrast color. That way, this will show this line that separates the save and publish from the icon. Okay, great. So let's go back to the row. our group combo button container. Let's go to layout. We're going to do the min width as 10. We're going to fit width to content. And we'll do the min height as 10 and fit height to content. Let's go to appearance. We're going to remove the style. We are going to go down to shadow style and put outset. The horizontal offset will be 0. The vertical offset will be 7. The blur radius will be 30. And the spread radius will be minus 10. And the box shadow color is going to be, oops, I got to move this up. Box shadow color is going to be primary. And let's go under style down to create a new style. And I already did this earlier, but I'll call this new one a combo button. And then click back on the icon because I forgot to save the style here. So we'll go under style. We'll go down to create a new style. And we'll call this combo button. Create. So now let's take a look at the preview. And there we go. Oh, what I need to do is add a hover state on the icon. So let's make sure the icon's highlighted. Let's go edit style. We'll go over to the conditional. We want to define a new condition. When this material icon is hovered, we want to change the background color. And it's going to come up as primary. We'll put 80% for the color opacity. So let's go take a look. And there we go. We have our hover. And what we'll want to do is add, go to the combo group. So let's go back to the design tab. If we click on the button that isn't spelled correctly and correct that, let's go to the edit style for the primary combo button. Go down to the select parent child. We want to select the group combo button container. We want to edit the style, and under conditional, I want to define another condition. When this group is hovered, we want to change the box shadow style from outset to none. Let's click back on the appearance tab, go down to select a property. Select a property to define a new transition. And I'm going to have to shrink the screen because it's not showing up. There we go. So we'll click on that drop down and we're going to choose the box shadow. Box shadow style. We can do EaseInOut. Let's try that one on this one. So let's go take a look. And so when we hover over, the shadow goes away. So it looks like you're pressing down on the button. And I see a little bit of difference in the ease in out. So that's nice. Okay, so now we want to put on our focus group. So let's go back to the design tab. Move that over a little bit. And let's go pick a group focus. Pop that on the page. Let's call this, I called the other one combo button. Let's call this one button combo. And we want to choose the material icon, keyboard arrow down, which is this icon right here. I did rename my other one just so that it's easier later on to be able to figure out what it is. So let's click on that. And in here I have a button. Oops. Let's choose the material icon keyboard. Let's choose the group focus button combo and go to layout, change the container layout to column. And we'll leave the size for the moment. Let's click on the button that we just put in. And we want to go to appearance. We want to change the style to white text button left. And save as draft would be the button text. Now, if we look at this white text button left, what I did was I copied the primary button, took away the background, I changed the background color to white because this could have a shadow on it if you really wanted it. I changed the text color to our default text color, button hover, primary. Since we are working with a primary button, I want the hover color to also be primary, and then the font color to be contrast on the hover. And I switched, all the buttons have center text, I switched it to left. And so that's why I'm calling it the white text button left. 16 references the font size, 400 references the font weight, and 1 represents the line spacing. Okay, back to design. Let's copy our left white button. Copy again. Change these to unpublish. Again, publish. And then archive for the last one. So let's go look at our longest one, and our longest one happens to be 150. That's great. So let's click on the group focus button combo, go to layout, change the width to 150, and go and change the minimum height to 10, making sure that the fit height to content is checked. Let's go back to appearance. What we want to do is offset it from the top a little bit, or that's what I do. You can do what you would like. And then I need to move it over just in case that the button is on the edge of a form. We want to be able to make sure that the drop down, the group focus, is visible. So let's minus 120, too much, 102. And then get it to show up. Let's go look at it now. It's not going to show up, even if we click on it, because we didn't tell it that it needed to show up. So let's click on the material icon keyboard arrow down. We're on the Appearance tab. Go to Start Edit Workflow. We want to go to Create an Action, Element Actions, Show, in the Element dropdown. We want to show the Group Focus button combo. Click back on the Design tab. Yep, that's the right one. And under Conditional, we want to, when Group Focus button combo is visible, this element isn't clickable. That way, when you click on it, it opens. You can click on it and it closes. If you don't tell it that that's going to happen or that it's not clickable, then you would have to click off somewhere else other than this icon to close. So let's go check. There it is. We can click on it to close it. So that's it. The only other thing that I have done with this is that I put on I use Classify as a plugin, and I add classes to some of these things. So now if I start tabbing through the focus shows up on whatever I've tabbed to. So that if you happen to not use a mouse, you can still tab through it. The only thing that I have to find is some sort of JavaScript to get the focus onto the group focus so that you can actually select one of these things. Ooh. And that's it. Thank you.